maybe not as big as you are. Can you talk a little bit about your Disney history and what playing the role of Cassandra means to you?
Yeah, I grew up in Anaheim, and you know, I had family members who worked at the park. My uncle was a kid of the kingdom back in the day. My second cousin still works at the park in entertainment. And so I grew up like coming to the park and going backstage, and the only thing I ever wanted to do was work at Disneyland in entertainment. And there we go, Pocahontas. And you know, I ended up doing that, and then I was like, I want to be the voice in the sky, and I was fortunate enough to be asked
Magical.
To record Magical that played every summer for 5 years. And then the last one was like, I just want to voice a character for Disney. And you know, and I had auditioned for Rapunzel. But when I went to see the movie. No, I went to see it, and then I heard that Mandy Moore got it, and she doesn't know this because we just met today, but like I've been a huge fan of hers. Like, I'm missing you like candy. I know all the songs, I've seen all the movies. Huge fan. So when I found out that it was Mandy, I was like, oh my god, that's so perfect. You know, I auditioned for Frozen. We all know what happened with that one.
Did y'all just hear that tongue click right now?
Oh, snap.
So when this came along, and I've done a lot of voiceover work before, but when this came along, it was honestly the first audition experience or voiceover that where I was actually my own voice, where I didn't have to like alter it at all. And so it was like really dream come true, but also full circle moment, just because I had auditioned for the movie, and now getting to be like a character in the series is just super cool. So I'm a total Disney nerd, Disney girl through and through. It's an honor and a privilege and nothing but a dream come true for me.
Once I saw Eden's, there was a video of her that we had seen. Shereen Prigmore.
What? Are you going to show your screensaver?
Oh yeah. Can you guys get a tight on that? This is my actual screensaver right now. Hold on. Can we get a shot of that? That is actually her as Pocahontas.
It's me as Pocahontas.
This is my everything. Is Eden as Pocahontas. Pocahontas was the first movie I worked on, so working on Pocahontas and then working with her is some kind of circle. But when we heard, when I heard Eden's voice and saw like a video that was on YouTube, the character of Cassandra had lived in kind of this huge idea for so long, but when I saw Eden sing and that is her, like the laser just went like exactly who she became solid in my mind when I saw that. It was very
What did that laser sound like again?
It was a single beam of light. There was smoke came into the room. It was very dramatic.
Laser magic.
It's Disney. They have them installed in all the meeting rooms.
Jeremy, this is
star.
Your first time voicing an animated character. Obviously.
You're welcome.
You guys, he seriously doesn't like that.
You haven't written at all.
You should have seen him backstage when Jeremy walked out. He was like, all right.
That's not true. I did threaten to leave, but I did not.
Okay, he's clearly working through some stuff. Just keep laughing for him. I love it. It makes him feel good. Love you, Zach.
And obviously, Varian has become a fan favorite. So how did you prepare for this role?
Oh, man. So many push-ups. I love Varian so much. I was, like, a couple years ago, I got an opportunity to audition for it. And I've auditioned for, like, maybe 3 animated things ever. So I was like, I'm not gonna get this. And it was just a lot of fun. They kind of just let me do whatever with it. And I just kind of went in and had a blast. And they gave it to me. So I was like, okay, great. And it's been an incredible experience. I was talking earlier that the first time I went in and saw, what is it called, the animatic, which is like after the storyboard, but before it's fully animated, it's like a kind of half animated. We went in and they had animated to my character doing the first episode. and Chris was there, I was like laughing and crying at the same time. All my Disney dreams were coming true in front of my eyes. It was the most, because
it was cute, you guys.
They'd give me the script and I just kind of like did my own thing with it. I just like was being super zany and super crazy, and I've been doing a lot of TV lately and you're like not allowed to do that. You know, so like Mandy, you know, I was just like kind of like flailing all over the place. It was fun, and then they capped all of it, and I was like, ah, that's me. So yeah, it was great, and he's so adorable, and he's just great. I love it. You know, it's weird because he's only been in one episode so far, and he's in a lot more to come. So. The fact that the response has been so wonderful just from one episode, I couldn't be happier.
When I got home,